Welcome to a battle royale between two of the hottest TVs of 2015. On your left is the Samsung Js9500 LED TV, and on your right is the LG EG9600 OLED television. Now, two totally different display types, but they are some of the best that we're gonna see this year, and we wanna see how the two stack up against each other. Let's start with aesthetics. With the Samsung JS9500, you've got a little bit of a thicker bezel around the edge, and that's decorative. We've got a stainless steel looking bezel here. Part of that's gonna cover up the edge lights on the panel. Whereas with the LG, we have almost zero bezel, which really helps accentuate how thin the panel is. Speaking of thin, the Samsung JS9500 is not a particularly thin TV, and that's because it has full array local dimming backlight system, and those LEDs have to go somewhere. As for the LG OLED, there is no backlighting system, so it's extremely thin, up top anyway. Once you get down to where all the electronics are, it actually ends up being just as thick as the Samsung. Speaking of electronics, Samsung puts the brains of its operation inside this outboard rig it calls a One Connect box. So basically you connect everything to this one little box, and then one cable runs up to the television, and that can ease installation, but it is one more piece to be concerned about. It's probably worth mentioning here too that the Samsung has four HDMI inputs, while LG stepped down to three this year. So how about remotes? Well, LG's actually got bigger this year and added a whole bunch of buttons. It's still a motion style remote, a magic motion remote, so you just point it at the screen and wave it around like you would a Wii remote. Samsung's got a little bit trimmer, and they added a little pointer button, so the cursor doesn't come up on the screen until you press and hold this button. And we've actually got fewer buttons here than in the past, so each company went a different direction with their motion controlled remotes. Both TVs have very powerful processors in them, so they both start up very quickly, and they're quick to load apps and run their own individual but similar operating systems. For Samsung, that would be Tizen. It's a card style interface and lays out all your apps down around the bottom. If you press a menu key, you get a whole bunch more options, including a numerical keypad, which will allow you to control your Blu-ray player or your set-top box, for instance. You can also control your DVR with this so that everything is in one place. Although I will say that's a whole lot of stuff to go through. LG continues on with the second generation of its webOS system, and we'll admit right away, this is our favorite smart TV operating system. It uses a card style interface along the bottom. This was a first for LG. Again, you have access to all of your apps and nearly all of your functions in one place, even your sources. You can line up your own personal favorite TV channels along here, right next to your apps if you want to. And of course, getting to picture settings is very quick. There's a little quick access menu. And then if you want to dive deeper, you can get to the entire menu here. It's the entire TV's operating system in one interface. Okay, now for the fun stuff. Let's talk about picture quality. And the first thing I have to mention is viewing angle. With the Samsung JS9500, you've got a very narrow sweet spot. When you're dead center on it, it looks incredible. But move off just a little bit to the right or the left, or stand up even, and it starts going downhill in a hurry. With the LG OLED, on the other hand, there is no sweet spot. Well, there is, it's just everywhere in the room. In fact, aside from standing directly behind the TV, every angle looks amazing. The picture quality does not change at all, and that's a huge advantage. So for a few of the next elements, it's gonna be more tell than show. Because of the limitations of the monitor you're watching this video on, you're not gonna be able to see some of what we're talking about. Next, let's talk about black level. Now, the LG OLED's black level is superior, and that's because OLED is a self-emitting technology. So when it's off, it's off. The blacks are as black as they can possibly be. With that said, the JS9500 exhibits some excellent black levels of its own, some of the best we've ever seen from an LED-based television. And for most people, it's not going to be a stark contrast until you actually stack them directly up against each other like this. As for brightness, it's a very tight race, with the LG OLED just barely edging out the JS9500. Again, you need to be in the sweet spot with the JS9500 Samsung in order to get the full effect of its brightness. And in fact, it can hit 1000 nits of brightness, which preps it nicely for HDR going forward. But The OLED right now with this 1080p content coming from a Blu-ray player looks a little bit brighter. And when you combine that with excellent black levels, you get this really huge amount of contrast, and that's what's so striking about this TV. The JS9500's full array local dimming is extremely effective, but it does have its limitations. With any LED LCD TV, you're gonna get a little bit of this halo effect where there's a sort of a wash around a bright object on a dark background. Most of the time, that's not a big deal, but you know, when you see scenes where you have that bright object, dark background, you're gonna see something like this. Whereas with an OLED, since there's no backlight, you'll never have that halo effect. As for color, both displays are excellent. Out of the box, they look great, but with a professional calibration, they're absolutely gonna knock you out. Now I wanna talk about a point that I did not expect to be such a big deal, but it is. It's judder. The Samsung JS9500 has excellent processing, and so it takes a 24 frame per second video and performs processing to make it look very smooth on screen without introducing that soap opera effect. It's just really good at that. The LG, on the other hand, not so much. Part of the problem with the LG is that that brightness creates extreme flicker anytime there's judder, so it exacerbates the issue. And I've noticed this happens with 30 frame per second content that you watch on TV too. For anybody who's sensitive to this sort of thing, it's going to be a major distraction, and it's really the only major holdback I have on the OLED TV. So if you've been keeping tabs, you know it's a pretty tight race. Both are excellent televisions. With the Samsung, you've got really good black levels, nice brightness for great contrast. The color is excellent. It's just that the off-axis viewing is really bad. Whereas with the OLED, you've got superior black levels and brightness for better contrast, excellent color, but then there's that major judder problem. So for me, I'm almost at a draw until I bring up the price. Haven't discussed that yet. The Samsung 65 inch behind me retails for $5,000. The LG OLED, on the other hand, same size television, retails for $4,000 more for a whopping $9,000. Now, I don't know about you, but that really starts swaying my decision. And in this case, I'm gonna have to say, I think that the Samsung is a more practical television because it's got excellent performance and it's not going to absolutely decimate your pocketbook, even though it's pricey itself. On the other hand, if you want the best picture quality money can buy, there's no doubt the LG OLED wins out in that match. So I guess it depends on where your priorities are, but now you know how these two amazing TVs stack up against each other.